Capri, what the fuck?
Damn. That's a shitty angle. What's going on, y'all? It's Fat Brandon, aka King Fat, aka King Fat, aka Fat Brandon, aka Mr. Blue Skies, aka The Hunters, aka King of Motherfucking Westlands. I just kind of wanted to make this little video. I know it's a little bit late, but I wanted to make a little video of kind of the behind the scenes and I guess the making of the Thought Hunters music video. Because it was a pretty fun music video and a pretty fun song overall, and I just kind of wanted to go over it with you guys a little bit, talk to you guys about it. You know, for those people who are interested in that kind of thing, I'm not going to sit here and pretend I'm this major artist sent to a huge label. I got hits upon hits. Like, I literally just dropped my first studio album, so, you know, it's nothing that serious. But I kind of want to build up a little catalog of videos like this. So you guys can join me while I make and eat a quick sandwich. And while I talk to you guys about Thought Hunters. So Thought Hunters stylized as Thought Hunters Z, like kind of like Dragon Ball Z, and I know you guys can tell that if you watch Dragon Ball, you know by the logo of the cover art on that song. With that song, mainly I kind of wanted to take things back to my musical roots a little bit, you know, just kind of do like something a little silly, something just a little fun. I mean, there's a couple of good little hard-hitting bars that are in that song, like here, we got a little co-host. This is Mistletoe, just adopted her a few days ago with the wife, a little two-year-old black cat. They found her in a dumpster. She's gonna be joining me today on my shoulder, a little monkey. But back to what I was saying, I just kind of wanted to go back to my musical roots a little bit, do something silly, kind of like a little goofy joke like song. Like, the song wasn't necessarily meant to take itself too seriously, but Mistletoe, you can't eat that. Yeah, it's a great idea. Have a cat on your shoulder while you're making food. That's worked out really well in the past. I'm sure cat owners know, but just kind of wanted to make a little silly song, and I guess it was pretty silly. There were some hard bars there, and here and there. She's about to jump off my shoulder. Fuck, your claws hurt really bad. What you doing, Mistletoe?
To come out of the closet.
No. She's here looking at me right now. Looking at me like I did something wrong. What a good song, Thought Hunters. Took a lot of inspiration from like the 2013 era of like bass rap. Specifically on the hook, there's a lot of Ruben Slick influence, specifically with that, like the soft spokenness, like the me and my gang, we Thought Hunters, like that kind of demeanor and flow and delivery of the bars was heavily inspired by some of Ruben Slick's work. Shout out to Ruben Slick. If you don't fuck with them, tap in with them. He's got some pretty crazy music out, really outlandish song titles. I can think of about five names of songs that have just the hard R N word in them. The music video wasn't really planned. It was kind of like a spur of the moment thing. I was going to 12 Oaks Mall, which is the nicest mall in I guess the general area. If you're from the Metro Detroit area, you know. One of the nicer malls in the area. It's not actually very nice compared to Great Lakes Crossing and from what I've been told, Somerset. But we went there. Me and my brother Turk Work, shout out Turk Work for sliding through and recording the video for me, helping me out with all that shit, giving me ideas, just chopping it up overall. Big love to Turk Work. He slid through, he helped me film. We just kind of walked around the mall for a little bit because I wasn't really too familiar with the layout since I've only been there like 10-ish times in the past 3 years. So we were just kind of scoping out the scene, you know, finding places to film and shit. We settled at first by this escalator area, and you know, we just kind of hit it off from there. We did, I want to say, like two or three takes over there, and while we were over there, we talked to a realtor and her husband. They shot a little bit of behind the scenes footage, I guess, which was pretty funny seeing that on her Instagram story the next day. Shout out to the realtor. But yeah, it was a pretty fun experience. And then from there we moved on. We found a jewelry stand, like one of those funny cheap jewelry stands that tries to sell you bubblegum wrapper shit for like Saks Fifth pricing. There was an Indian man that was working behind the counter, and I gaslit him for 20 minutes on rap culture for him to allow me to come and film behind his jewelry stand, which was probably one of the highlights of that video in my opinion. We met up with some little white boys in the food court, and they were we did a couple takes with them, and it was a funny take where I was like lunging at the camera and they had to hold me back, which was another highlight of that video in my opinion. Overall, with that music video, we just kind of wanted to go around the mall, see what we could do, see what we could get away with, just cause mischief. Kind of like that one, I don't know if it was like a documentary or just like a mall vlog that Odd Future did back in the day, where they were just running around acting like fucking hooligans. We were kind of, I guess, doing that, but on a very toned down level. If you guys haven't tapped in with that music video or the song, do both for me right now. Do a 2-in-1. Go to my YouTube channel, tap in with the music video, open up Spotify, Apple Music, YouTube Music, SoundCloud, whatever you listen to music on, and look up Fat Brandon, Thought Hunters, with the Z at the end, don't forget. Another thing I'd like to say, recently, within the past week, I got a community guideline strike on one of my videos called Shitpostville 2 with the Vengeance. A very special video to me. A lot of effort was put into that video, not just by me, but by the fellow collaborators who were involved in the production of that short film. So, needless to say, I'm a little bit unhappy about that, but it's all good. I still have the file on my computer. I might do a couple little like touches on it, like remaster it. Like, the other parts were fine, but for whatever reason, my segment for that film was very silent. I go back in and try to enhance the volume on that as much as I can to make it sound more clear. Because I know that was like one of the issues that I had with that film, is it was really quiet for my part. Because of the fact that I got a community guideline strike on my channel, clearly I'm not going to upload it to YouTube again. I'm going to figure something out though. If I have to upload it to like Vimeo or Dailymotion or something, or even just put like a Mediafire link in the description of one of my videos or the comments, we'll figure something out.
The editing on the Thought Hunters music video was done in collaboration with my brother Ray Mag. Shout out to Ray Mag, did your thing on them shine effects. That's something that's a little bit out of my skill set. So shout out to you for hooking me up, showing me love on that, doing that for me. If you guys want to tap in with some funny content, tap in with Ray Mag's channel. I'll leave a link in the description, and it'll also probably be in the description of the Thought Hunters music video. But again, huge shout out to Ray Mag for helping me out with editing of that music video and doing all those after effects. And with that, I'm out of here.
Me and my gang, we thought hunters. No chops, we rolling with loud thunder. No greens, we thumbing through blue hundreds. I robbed that void and took his thought to the luncheon.